Hello, brothers and sisters. November 3rd here, 2022. Brother Andrew Robert asked me to do a video on mixing God and mammon. Most of the ministers on the planet today advise doing that when they mix up Romans 13 and they forget about Matthew 6:24. So I'll try and help everybody here today what it means about mixing God and mammon, and why people like to mix common law with God's law. When Deuteronomy 4:2 was put together there, it says, "Don't add to my law, don't take away from my law, this I command you." This was to reflect Exodus 20, 3 through 5, where he says, don't bow down to those false gods you may have created images of. And he said, don't serve them. So if anybody's added to any of God's law that you can find in Exodus chapter 20, then he's not to be followed. He's heathen. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verses 2, Deuteronomy 12, 32. Make it clear that you're not to walk in any ordinances that have been added to God's law or taken away from God's law, as you can see in Leviticus chapter 18, verses 3 through 5. This is simply verboten. You can't have any gods in addition to God. There's only one God. There's only one God making law. So when you read Matthew 6:24, you cannot mix God and mammon. And you see it again in the 16th chapter of Luke. Read the whole chapter. You know what's being talked about there to reflect Leviticus 18:3-5. Give us an understanding what Christ was talking about in Matthew 15:9. In vain do you worship me, teaching for doctrine the commandments of men. Kind of forgetting Numbers 15:15 there, one ordinance for all. That's the common law that we are to keep in mind. Not Magna Carta 12:15 bait and switch so people would forget all about God's law and they could start imposing statute, code, and regulation upon you. So the false Jew owned by the king could get away with all kinds of perverse type of things because the king owned them and they could do what they wanted to as far as making law, statute, code, and regulation. It was all a scam. So the pulpit would be teaching you to mix God and mammon in violation of Matthew 6:24. Mammon is man's law for making money. That is the merchanter. Those false Jews coming into port on their boats. Well, the ocean was myrrh, and the chanting was what they were doing. They were praying to God for good fortune in their trades. They became known as the merchanters. That became known as the lex mercantoria, the law of the sea, the law of the Jewish merchants. That's how you got statute, code, and regulation, and people were told to submit to it, mixing God and mammon, Matthew 6:24. So now we know mammon is the false code of the merchants that were Jewish, the merchanters. That's what mammon is. It's been added to and taken away from God's law directly. Ignorant and in violation of Deuteronomy 4:2, Deuteronomy 12:32. So I hope that's helped explain mixing God and mammon and how it's relative to that sneak in, bait and switch confidence game called common law, which is a total scam. Bait and switch was put in to remove the law of the land, which was the Ten Commandments King Alfred the Great had put in place in 880 AD. King John and his Jewish merchants didn't like that very much. They had to get rid of those Ten Commandments, so they brought in common law that merchant law is a bait and switch. What a scam, with the king saying he owns the Jews and they're immune from all the law. Meanwhile, he's got them in there scamming people left and right with usury. That's what it was about, folks. The Magna Carta was a bait and switch exercise to get rid of the Ten Commandments. That's what it was all about. And that's why it's mammon. It's deliberately planned very deceptively by the kings of the past to overthrow God's law. Mammon and mixing God's law is verboten. So now that you've caught on, you should probably never ever be confused about that again. You can't be compelled to mix statute, code, or regulation with God's law. That's the laws of the various governments of the day they wish to impose upon you. Statute, code, and regulation. That's why you've got those international covenants on civil and political rights, social and economic and cultural rights. They're put there to overwrite that statute, code, and regulation if anybody should wake up to the fact that it's been added to God's law and take away from God's law in violation of his directive. So I hope that clears it up, folks. Blessings. Bye for now.